हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज रिवीजन लेक्चर ऑफ चैप्टर 1 इंटीजर्स सब्जेक्ट मैथमेटिक्स एंड फॉर क्लास 7। इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल रिवाइज ऑल कॉन्सेप्ट दैट वी हैव लर्न इन चैप्टर 1 इंटीजर्स। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट, वी विल समराइज चैप्टर 1 इंटीजर्स एंड आफ्टर दिस आई विल प्रोवाइड यू द असाइनमेंट ऑफ चैप्टर 1 एंड वी विल डिस्कस होमवर्क सॉल्यूशन ऑफ लेक्चर नंबर 12। So before starting this, let me tell you about integers. Let us start the lecture with the meaning of integers. So integers are the, what are integers? Integers are the bigger collection of numbers. They include whole numbers as well as negative numbers. They include whole numbers as well as negative numbers, and negative numbers are the numbers which are less than zero. So we can say that it is a bigger collection of numbers that includes whole number and negative numbers. So this is the meaning of integer. Now in first statement, what we are going to discuss is representation of integers on the number line and their addition and subtraction. So first, how to represent the integers? Let us recall about the number line. In the middle of this line, we have the zero, and to the right of zero, we have the numbers like 1, 2, 3, and so on. And to the right of the numbers, they are known as positive integers. And to the left of 0, we have numbers like minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, and so on. And these numbers are known as negative integers. So to the right of 0, we have the positive integers. And to the left of 0, we have the negative integers. And one more thing you have to add, that 0 is neither positive integer nor it is a negative integer. So integers can, we can say that integers can be divided into two parts, negative integers and positive integers. After this, let us discuss how to represent integers on a number line. Suppose you have to represent 3 on the number line. For that, you have to represent 3 here, because 3 is a positive integer and you have to represent to the right of 0. So this is the representation of integer. Now, next statement is, we are going to learn about representation of integers we have done, and then we will learn how to add and subtract the integers. For adding and subtracting the integers, we must remember 4 points that how to add and subtract the integer. First one is, let me take the example of these. First one is, when you are adding 2 negative integers, suppose I am having a negative integer, I am having a negative integer, I am adding them, I will always get a negative sign, and for numerical value, you have to sum up the numerical values which are given for the addition. So the sign will be of negative. Let me take this by an example. Suppose I am having minus 7 and I am adding minus 3. For adding them, I will get minus sign, and numerical values you have to add, so I will get minus 10. This is the first point you have to remember while adding addition and subtraction of integers. Second one and third one are same. If you are adding 1 negative and 1 positive, or I can say 1 positive or 1 negative, sign will be of that number which have the higher numerical value. And for number, you have to subtract the smaller number from the bigger one. Let me take one example related to the concept. Suppose I am taking 7 and I am adding minus 10. Plus minus, as I know, it will give you minus, and it is minus 10. Now we have the same concept here, that when I am having positive and a negative, I have to subtract the smaller number from the bigger one. So 10 minus 7 is 3, and for the sign, you have to put the sign of the number which is having high numerical value. Here we have 10 is bigger than 7, and 10 is with negative sign, so I will write minus 3. So 7 minus 10 is minus 3. Let us consider one more example. Suppose I am having minus 7 and you are adding it with plus 10. 1 is negative, 1 is positive. For number, for the numerical number, you have to subtract the smaller number from the bigger one. 10 minus 7 is 3. And for the sign, you have to put that sign which is with the higher, bigger number. Here 10 is with 10 is bigger than 7 and 10 is with plus sign. So I will write plus 7. So 7 minus 7 plus 10 is plus 3. Now fourth point is whenever you are adding two positive integers, whenever you are adding two positive integers, you will get a positive integer and the sign, and for numerical value you have to add the numerical value. Suppose 7 plus 3 you have to add, simply the sign will be positive and you have to add these numbers, so it will be plus 10. So this is how you can add and subtract the integers. Now next comes, we will learn properties of integers. First property is integers are closed under addition. What this statement means, if you are adding two integers, the result is also an integer. Integers are closed under addition. It means if you are adding any two integers, the result is also an integer. And they are closed under subtraction. Same for subtraction. If you are subtracting any two integers, the result is again an integer. And same for multiplication. If you are multiplying any two integers, you will get an integer. So integers are closed under addition, subtraction and multiplication. This I am repeating, that if you are adding two integers, you will get an integer, and if you are subtracting two integers, you will get an integer, and if you are multiplying any two integers, you will get an integer. Next property is addition and multiplication are commutative for integers. That is, if you are adding any two number, irrespective of their order, you will get the same result. Suppose A plus B you are adding, this is same as B plus A. This is known as commutative property over addition for integers. Same for multiplication, only the difference is you have to change the sign. You have to change the sign. Here it is plus and so here it will be minus, because we are learning commutative over multiplication. So A into B is equal to B into A, where A and B are integers. As we are dealing with integers, so we will take the values of A and B as integers. So we can say commutative property over addition is A plus B equals to B plus A, and over multiplication it is A into B is equal to B into A, and where A and B are integers. Now next property is addition and multiplication are associative for integers. Associative means, if first I am taking associative over addition. If you are adding any three integers and you are adding them, like if you are adding first two integers with the third one, or you are adding last two integers with the first one, the result remains same. I am repeating it. If you are adding first two integers with the last one, or you are adding last two integers with the first one, the result remains same. And same for associative over multiplication. If you are multiplying first two integer with the third one, or you are multiplying last two integer with the first one, the result remains same. And where A, B, C or all belongs to integers. So this is associative property over addition and multiplication. Now next comes is, zero is an additive identity for integers. First, additive identity. Additive identity is the number which, when added to any integer, will give you the same result as integer. Suppose you are adding 0 to integer A, you will get the result as A. What number should be added to A so that you will get the A? Here the number is 0. So we can say 0 is the additive identity for integers, because whenever 0 is added to any integer, we will get the same result. So this is known as additive identity of integers. Now next comes multiplicative. 1 is the multiplication. Here this is 1, not minus 1. They are just implies. 1 is multiplicative in identity for integers. That is, A into 1 or equals to 1 into A, that it give you A. What this statement says, that a multiplicative identity is the number which, when multiplied to any integer, will give the same result to that of integer. Suppose A, I am taking any integer, and by what number should this A multiply so that I will get A? Obviously that number is 1. So we can say 1 is multiplicative identity for any integer, for every integer, because when any integer multiplied with 1, I will get the same integer. So this is multiplicative identity of integers. Now next property is integers shows distributive property of multiplication over addition. What this statement says, that is a into b plus c is equal to a into b plus a into c. Suppose if you are having any number outside the bracket and any sign outside the bracket, that number along with the sign get distributed with each term in the bracket. This is what the distributive property says. That is a into b plus c equals to a into b plus a into c. Here a and this multiplication sign is outside the bracket. As the name suggests, distributive, it means we have to distribute. So this a and this sign get distributed to each term in the bracket. A into b plus a into c, and where a, b, c are integers. So this is a distributive property of multiplication over addition. Now next concept comes here, how to multiply the integers. That is, first one is product of a positive integer with a negative integer, or I can say negative integer product with a negative to a positive, we get a negative integer with the result minus ae. Let me take an example. Suppose you are multiplying 3 into minus 5. So you will get minus 15. Whenever one positive and one negative integer are multiplied, you will, in any order, you will get a negative integer. Now second result says, whenever you are multiplying two negative integers, or I can say whenever you are multiplying two positive integers, the result is always a positive integer. The result is always a positive integer because multiplication of two integers always give an integer. This we can say by closure under multiplication property. Now next is, if you are multiplying any number of integers having negative sign, or I can say if you are multiplying n number of negative integers, then if the number of negative integers are even, then their multiplication I will get is a positive integer. Again I am repeating, if you are multiplying n number of integers and where n is an even number of integers, the result is always a positive integer. And same, if I am multiplying n odd number of integers, odd number of integers if I am multiplying, I will get a negative integer. This is an important property you have to remember in multiplication of integers. If you are multiplying even number of negative integers, you will get a positive integer, and if you are multiplying odd number of integers, negative integers, you will get a negative integer. Here already negative is there, so I have written only integers because it is obvious that they are negative because I have put the sign. Now next topic is how to divide the integers. Suppose I am dividing, if I am dividing one positive and one negative, or I can say one negative and one positive, I will always get a negative integer, a negative number. Suppose you are dividing 2 divided by minus 1, or you can say minus 2 divided by 1. The result is always minus 2 by 1. If you are dividing one negative, positive, one negative, or I can say one negative, one positive, the result is a negative number. Second is, if you are dividing two negative integers, or I can say if you are dividing two positive integers, you will get a positive number. Now one more result, that is for any integer a, when a is divided by 1, you will always get 1. This I can explain with an example. If 7 is divided by 1, any integer when divided by 1, you will get the same integer. Here I am getting 7. So this is the explanation. And a divided by 0, that is not defined, because we can't take, this is the complete part, this is total number of parts, and we have nothing in this, so this is not defined. We can't take anything from nothing, so that's why this is not defined. A divided by 0 is not defined. So this is all about chapter number 1. We have briefly discussed about the topics that are coming in chapter 1. Now let us discuss homework solution of lecture number 12. Question number 5, 4, 5 and 6 I have given to you. क्वेश्चन नंबर फोर आई एम नॉट टेकिंग, क्वेश्चन नंबर सिक्स आई एम टेकिंग दैट एंड दैट इज सिक्स पार्ट आई एम टेकिंग 7.75 डिवाइडेड बाय 0.25. यू हैव टू फर्स्ट डिवाइडेड, फर्स्ट रिमूव द डेसिमल. फॉर दैट यू हैव टू रिमूव द डेसिमल. फर्स्ट यू हैव टू रिमूव द डेसिमल. फॉर दैट यू हैव टू डिवाइड बाय 100. बोथ द टर्म्स यू हैव टू डिवाइड इट बाय 100 बिकॉज आफ्टर द डेसिमल वी आर हैविंग टू डिजिट. Now next step, you have to convert this division into multiplication. For that you have to do the reciprocal of this last term which is just after the division. We are having 100 over 25. Now you have to solve. Remember this, you will not cancel this to this. Because whenever you have 10, 100 or 1000 or 10,000 and so on in the denominator, it would be better not to cancel that. Because it will help in putting the decimal at the end. So that's why I am cancelling these two only. And they get cancelled at 31. 25 with the table of 25. 25 banja and this get cancelled at 31. So I am getting 31 into 100. That is 3100 over 100. And that is equal to 31.00. Or I can say 31. Now ninth part is 2.73 divided by 1.3. Remove the decimal in this step. Then convert this division into multiplication. For that, take the reciprocal of the term which is just after the division. After this only you have to cancel these two. I will not cancel 100 with any of the term in the numerator because it will help in putting the decimal. So this get cancelled at 21. 21 into 10, now 210 over 100, that will give you 2.1. Now question number 6 is, a vehicle covers a distance of 43.2 km in 2.4 liters of petrol. How much distance will it cover in 1 liter of petrol? Simply the question is asking that if it is given that the vehicle covers this distance in 2.4 liters of petrol, that how much distance will it cover in 1 liter of petrol? Here I will apply the unitary method. The thing which you have to find must be written on right side. So here I have to find the distance, so that must be written on right side. Now distance covered in 2.5 liters of petrol we have given is 43.2 km and we have to calculate the distance covered in 1 liter of petrol. Obviously we have to divide them for getting 1 liter of petrol, distance covered in 1 liter of petrol. Now this is the division of decimal number, how you will divide. Same steps you have to apply. First remove the decimal, after this you have to change this division into multiplication. For that, take the reciprocal of the term which is just after the division. Now I am cancelling these two only. I will not cancel this because this will help me in putting the decimal. So I am cancelling these two and this get cancelled at 18. So a 180 over 10 will give you 18. So 18 kilometer is the distance that the vehicle will cover in 1 liter of petrol. This is the homework solution of lecture number 12. Now come to the assignment that you have to do. Here are the questions of assignment. This is your question number 1. Taking today as 0 on the number line, if the day before yesterday is 17 January, what is the day 3 days after tomorrow? You have to carefully read the questions at least twice or thrice, then you have to solve these questions. So this is question number 1. This is your question number 2. Now come to question number 3. This is your question number 3. After this, this is your question number 4. These two parts you have to solve. Question number 5. Question number 6. Question number 7. After this, question number 8, question number 9. In question number 9, you have the 9 parts, you have to solve them. Question number 10, and in question number 10, you have 6 parts. So this is all about the assignment. Now come to the homework. You have to solve question number 1 to 5 of assignment 1, that is of chapter 1, in your classwork notebook. If you don't have the notebook, you can solve in any notebook if you are having. And In the next lecture, I will give you the solution of this assignment and you please check the solutions of the questions which I have given from the solution lecture of assignment 1. So this is all about the revision lecture of chapter 1, that is of integers. Thank you.